This video will explain how to estimate the settlement of soft clay caused by the construction of embankment. Let's look at this example when we have a soil profile. And here we have sand, 2 meters of sand, and we have groundwater level, which is 1 meter below the ground surface. And below the sand, we have soft clay. So what is going to happen with soft clay when we build an embankment on top of that? It will settle. And we are given a compression index. If you don't know what compression index is, please watch my video. This is the link. This is very important property of soil. We use this property to estimate the settlement of soil under embankment. So what we want to do is we're going to build this embankment on top of the sand. And this embankment will be 3 meters high. And this embankment will generate some additional stress. And this stress will be applied to both sand and clay. But because clay is really soft, it's going to settle a lot compared to sand. And for this reason, we are going to estimate only the settlement of this clay layer. We are not going to estimate settlements of sand because it's not going to be that significant compared to clay. So if we look at the final picture, I think it will be going to look like this. There will be settlement. So this layer of clay will settle. And what we just want to know, we want to know how much it's going to settle as. S stands for settlement. We are also given the void ratio of this clay, and it's 1.8. We are also given the bulk density of the clay. It's 1.62 grams per cubic centimeters. And we're also provided some information about the sand that we have here on top of the clay, the unit weight of the sand above the groundwater level. So this one, it's 16 kilonewtons per cubic meters. And the unit weight of sand below the groundwater level, it's 18. It does make sense because when sand has some water, when it's saturated, it's a unit weight will be a little bit greater than the unit weight of the same sand when it's dry or only partially saturated. Okay, now let's look at this schematic diagram. I already put some numbers here, and I'm going to explain where we get all these values from. So first of all, we should be given the unit weight of the material that we use for the embankment construction. And in this case, it's going to be 19 kilonewtons per cubic meter. So it's given to us. And now we can calculate this additional stress that will be generated because of the construction of embankment. So we're going to use a formula that we calculate for effective stress, which is a unit weight of soil material times the thickness of this material. So we know that the unit weights that we're going to use for the soil in embankment is 19 kilonewtons per cubic meters, and the thickness is 3 meters. So it's going to give us 57 kilonewtons per square meters. So this is going to be the additional effective stress that will be generated, and it will be applied to this clay layer. So to estimate the settlement, we're going to use this formula. There are a few formulas that we can use to estimate the settlement, and this one is the most appropriate one because it gives us a compression index. And compression index was already provided, and this is what we're going to use. So compression index of this clay is 0.68. So this is the reason why we use this particular formula. So what we need to know is the H. So H stands for the thickness of the clay layer. And in this case, we are given it's 5 meters. We also need to know the initial void ratio of clay before we build the embankment. And it was also given to us, and it was 1.8. So it's a very large void ratio. And now I need to find this effective stress, which is here and here, and delta sigma. So delta sigma is this delta sigma that comes from the weight of the embankment. So we already know it, and we know that it will be 57 kilonewtons per square meters. What we need to find now is just this initial effective stress. You need to be careful when you find this value, because you need to find it right for the middle of the clay layer, not bottom and not top of the clay layer. So it should be in the middle. So you see it here, point A. I already put it here, point A. And the middle of the clay layer, if it's altogether 5 meters, the middle will be at 2.5 meters. So now let's estimate the effective stress. First, we'll start with the total stress. And we know that before we build any embankment, we have 1 meter of relatively dry sand. So 1 meter times 16 plus. Now we have another meter of sand that is saturated times 18. And we were given density, bulk density of the clay, which was 1.62. So to change it to unit weight, we'll multiply it by 9.81 gravitational acceleration. So we're going to have 1.62 times 9.81 will give us approximately 15.89 kilonewton per cubic meters. And this is the value that we're going to use here. Remember, it's half of the layer, 2.5 meters times 15.89. And it should give us approximately 73.7 kilonewton per square meters. So this is the total stress at point A. Now we're going to find the water pressure. So to find water pressure, we need to know how much water is above point A. Point A here, and groundwater level is here. So altogether, this HW will be 3.5 meters, right? So it's 1 meter in the sand and plus 2.5 meters in the clay. So we can say that the water pressure, 1 plus 2.5 multiplied by the unit weight of water, which I'm sure you already know, it's 9.81. That will give us approximately 34.3 kilonewton per square meters. Now let's find the effective stress at point A, which is the middle of the clay layer. It's total stress minus water pressure, 73.7 minus 34.3 will give us approximately 39.4 kilonewton per square meters. So this is the initial effective stress that exists in the clay mass before we built the embankment. And now we just use this formula to estimate the settlement of clay. So I'm going to write it here that settlement of clay, it's equal compression index already given to us, 0.68. It's this value. Then we multiply by H with the thickness of the clay mass, it's 5 meters. Divide by 1 plus initial void ratio of the clay before we built the embankment. It's also given 1.8. And then we have a log, standard log. And then the effective initial stress is 39.4 plus the additional effective stress due to embankment. Already found it, it's 57. And divide by the initial one, 39.4. That should give us approximately 0.47 meters. So this means that when we build embankment over time, we still don't know how long it's going to take, so watch my other videos. The settlement will be 0.47 meters. Thanks.